Hello everyone, this is Hoda Ganji and this is part of the video tutorial series on parametric design. So far we talked about a randomized pattern made out of circles. Now I'm going to show you how we can try some polygons or something and how we can create a pattern like this. But before doing that, I want to tell you a little bit about the visibility options in Dynamo. So let's say I have this node here and I have also this node here. What I'm interested in is only the product, which is this one. I don't want to see the dots, the curves or anything else. In that case, you can just right click on the node and remove the check mark for preview. And I can do that for the grid as well. Alright, so now what's left here is just the product or the circles. Don't worry about Revit, it's gonna come back later. Let me bring them back, bring this one back, and let's create some polygons. So under the geometry menu, we have an option for curves and we have polygons here. We also have rectangles. Let's try some polygons first. And there's a very useful item here for polygons which are inscribed within a circle. I want to try that because we already have the circles and everything, and you see as it says here the inputs are circles and the number of sides, so we can create a square, a hexagon or something, right? So I'm going to click on this one and the circles. Let me disconnect this option first. We don't want to patch it right away. To disconnect one of these links, you can simply click on it and click somewhere on the screen. I'm going to move it away. So this is going to be the circle. By default, this is on 5, right? So if I create a number slider to assign the number of sides of the polygon and put it here, I want to put this on integers because I want it to be like 3-sided, which is a triangle, 4-sided, which is a square, and so on. So I want to put this on 1, the steps should be on 1. Let me zoom in a little bit. How about we go from 3, the minimum size could be 3 if we want to have like a surface, and 3 is going to give us some triangles, and we can go like as far as 12 or something. I can attach this to the number of sides. Okay, and you see now it's creating some triangles. You can go with 4. What would be helpful here is to turn off the preview of the circles. Okay, so now it's 4 squares, 5, 6, 7 and so on. Okay, so if I want to create like something like this, they're hexagons, I can go with 6. As this is all parametric, it means that the outcome relies on the parameters that we assign. As soon as you change something in here, let's say if this is like 6, I want to go with 5, or that one is 8, I want to go with 6. As soon as I change something in here, it's going to reflect in the final pattern. Or I can move them further from each other, right? Now this time, instead of the circles, I want the polygons to create the surface. So I can connect this one over there, and the rest is easy. You can just use import geometries, and if you remember, we had import by geometry and import by geometries, and in my experience, import by geometries work a little bit in Revit. So I would go with that one and import them back into Revit.